Hello guys, in this lecture we will discuss about the multi-objective optimization. The topic is related to mathematical optimization problems which involves more than one or more than two objectives or objective function which is to be optimized simultaneously. This concept is used in decision making process when we have multiple criteria available and we want to take decision by fulfilling those criteria. For example, if you want to buy a car, then there are various objectives, like you want to minimize the cost of the car, means you want to buy a cheap car as possible, and as well as you want maximum comfort. So you have like two objectives. One is to you have to minimize the cost of the car. You want that the cheapest car would be available to you, but along with that you want the comfortable in that car, comfortable level in that car. So these two objectives are contradictory, means if you are increasing the comfort, it means your cost should be increased, and if you are decreasing your cost, it means your comfort should be decreased, but your objective is to maximize the comfort and minimize the cost. So in these types of scenarios, your single objective optimization problems or algorithms may not work properly, and most of the real world application, most of the real world problems are generally based on multi-objective optimization concepts. There are various applications of this multi-objective optimization, like we can include this field in engineering, like civil engineers and mechanical engineers may solve various problems related to their machines based on this optimization, and also in economics, logistics and field of sciences also use this field to make the decision with some defined trade-offs. So now we will explore the this field, and we will try to mathematically model the multi-objective optimization problems, and also study some of the solutions proposed in the textbooks and the literature about these types of problems. Okay, so here, if you want to suppose a problem is given to you and we want to mathematically model the multi-objective optimization concept, then a multi-objective optimization problem has multiple objectives, as the name suggests. So each of the objective either is minimized or maximized. So I can write define a function as to minimize or maximize f, which is a objective function, on some defined variable x with m objectives. M is a number of objectives which is going to 1 to capital M, okay, subject to some of the constraints. Now these constraints are the trade-offs. Suppose these constraints are used to define some of the trade-offs related to the applications, means what are the conditions which needs to be fulfilled before you are reached to the solution. Okay, so in order to find out the valid solutions, real world problems define some constraint functions. So these there are various types of constraint functions, and here we are mentioning only two types of constraint function. One is equality constraint, other is inequality constraint. So in this example, your g function gjx defined over x, and j may be 1 to j, so there may be j, capital J, inequality constraint defined over x. So the meaning of this gj is greater than 0 is means we have kept these number of inequality constraint defined over x, and the function h denotes the equality constraint. So we have k equality constraint which is defined over x. Okay, now inequality may be is greater than or equal to, is less than equal or equal to. So I can convert any equality function into other by multiplying minus 1. This is known as duality principle, This is also applicable with the fitness function or the objective function, where if the objective function or fitness function is minimization problem, then I can multiply it by the minus 1 and convert this problem into a maximization problem. Similarly, I can divide it by 1 and convert it to the maximization problem. So we will discuss it later. For the time being, the multi-objective optimization problem can be defined as a collection of fitness functions, that is fm of x, which is defined like this. So we have function f1, f2 and fm, and each of these function may be minimized or maximized function, and subject to the two constraint function or trade-offs, that is g h of x and h k of x, with the variable bounds. So the variable bounds means your variable x should be lie between the lower value of x and upper value of x. So these are the variable bound. Here x is a vector which contains a set of values. In this example, I consider some n set of values to represent a vector x. Okay, so this is the overall problem formulation for multi-objective optimization problem. Now if you have a solution x, if you have a solution x and if it satisfy all the constraint functions, like we have two constraint function, one is g, other is h. So if the solution satisfy the constraint functions, means satisfy the j plus k constraint function, we have j inequality and k equality constraint functions, then the solution or x is called feasible solution. We will use this term in the subsequent lecture, feasible solution. So feasible solutions are those solutions which satisfy the constraint functions. If any solution does not satisfy the constraint function, we call it as a infeasible solution. Infeasible solutions. Okay, so before we are going to solve any problem, we have to make a decision space D. And the decision space is the space where all the variables x, all the solutions which is represented by x, are defined in the variable bounds. Now once all the solutions are defined in the variable bounds, we will check for the feasibility of the solution by the applying the constraint function. So in the decision space, we have to check the constraint function and make the feasible solution, or called feasible space F. Now this feasible space only contain the feasible solutions. Now as the optimization problem, the task of the optimization problem is to select best solution between all alternative solution according to the objective defined. So we have to search for the best solution in the set of feasible solutions. Okay, so we are not looking for towards the infeasible solutions, because there is a waste of time and work. So first we apply the constraint function, define a feasible solution space, and between these feasible solution space, we have to look for the optimal solution which satisfy the all of the objectives in the objective function space. So this is about the how the problem is denoted mathematically in multi-objective optimization domain. Okay, now we will look for some of the more terms in this domain, in multi-objective optimization domain. So let's suppose in this we have two diagrams shown it here. We have already defined the problem, mathematical formulation of the multi-objective optimization, and we learned that we have a set of solutions which represent the decision variable space or feasible solution space. Generally we call these alternatively decision variable space and feasible solution space. Means we are generally treat only those solution which satisfy the constraint function, and in some problems it may possible that you are not defined any constraint function. In that case, the decision space is your feasible solution space. So generally we use these two terms interchangeably. Now for this set of diagram, for this diagram, we have a solution x which is defined over three dimensional space x1, x2 and x3. So the meaning of defining a solution in three dimensional space means a point represents three values like 1, 2, 3. This is a point which is defined as x, and this x value is of x1, and this is of x2, and this is of x3. So we have three dimensional solution defined in the decision variable space, and we have two objective functions. Let us suppose both of the objective function have minimization problems, so we have to minimize the f1 and f2, and we have generate of we have to calculate the value of f2 by putting this solution into it, and we are calculating the value of f1 by putting this solution into it. So suppose at a particular time when you put value x into f1, and suppose f1 is some function x like x square. This is for the example, it is not actual function, I am taking it for the sake of example. So suppose you have a given a function f1 is equal to x1 square, and you want to minimize it. So because it is a three dimensional function, I have to define it like in the dimension layer 1 to d xi square. So this function is converted into x1 square plus x2 square plus x3 square. It means it is 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. It means it is 1 plus 4 plus 9. It means it is 14. Similarly, if you have a function f2 which is x, so it is nothing but I is equal to 1 to d xi, it means it is 1 plus 2 plus 3, and the value is 6. So these two points, 6 and 14, so in this case your f1 represent x direction, so 14 and 6 is represented this point 14 and 6. So when we calculate the objective function values by any solution in multi-objective problem, it will generate another solution objective function space and known as objective space of the problem. So in multi-objective optimization problem, we have two spaces defined. One is decision variable space, in which the solutions are defined. Solution may have multiple dimensions, two-dimensional solution, three-dimensional or multiple dimensions may be there. And we have multiple objectives defined in the problem in multi-objective optimization. In this example, I consider only two objectives, that why this plot is 2D. And we have only two points to generate, to represent a solution or in the objective space. Okay. So this value Z is mapped with this solution X. So for all X in this decision space, there exists a point in this objective space Z, and which is denoted by Z1, Z2 and so on, Zm, and we call this set as Z. This is objective space. Okay, so this is the overall concept, and we will look further how we can use this two concept in order to solve the optimization problem related to it. Before going further, I am also describing you the concept of Pareto optimal set. What is Pareto optimal set? So let's discuss about this concept. What is Pareto optimal set? So to understand the concept of Pareto optimal solutions, let's take an example. So suppose there is a real world optimization problem, cantilever beam design problem. So we have to design a beam with two decision variables. One is diameter of the beam and the length of the beam. Now the beam has to carry a load P, and there are two defined objectives. The one objective is to, we have to minimize the weight, means we require a beam to be as lighter as possible, and we require minimum end deflection. Now this thing, minimum end deflection, is only possible when the beam is heavy. If beam is very lightweight, then the deflection is there at the end side, where the load is to be pull up or put up. Okay. So this objective function requires that your D and L should be minimized, means your dimensions of the problem should be, should have less values or smaller values. And if you have D and L as a smaller values, then your beam should not be rigid enough and it will lead to large end deflection. So these two objectives are contradicting each other. So we require a midway, an alternative solution and an alternative way so that both of the objectives may be fulfilled by some of the probabilities. Okay. Now, also there are two constraints defined over this problem. One is the maximum stress which is developed, and we denote that maximum stress as sigma max, is always less than the allowable strength. Sy is the allowable strength. And your end deflection is always less than the maximum developed stress. Okay, so this is the, these two are the constraint functions. Let's see how we can formulate this problem mathematically. So I write the formulas for the same. So the problem mathematically can be designed like in these formulations, and in this one, because we have two objectives, f1 is to minimize the weight and f2 is to minimize the end deflection. So this formula is given for the minimizing the weight, and which is this formula is for volume. So if the volume is minimized, then weight is minimized. So rho pi d square 4 into l, so pi d square of l upon 4 into rho. Rho is a constant which is given right here. And then we have to minimize the end deflection, which is given by 64 rho L cube. This is P L cube into 3 E pi D 4, and P is given as a constant. And the L and D is your decision variables. And the value for L and D decision variables are defined in between 10 to 50 mm for D and 200 to 1000 mm for L. So these are the variable bounds for this problem. Now there are two constraint functions. One is your sigma max is always less than Sy, that is your allowable strength. So your sigma max, which is also known as the max stress, the maximum stretch, which is given by 32 PL upon pi d cube, and it is always then maximum allowable strength, and the maximum allowable strength in this application is 30 MPa. Now this second objective function is your delta, which is your end deflection is always less than delta max. So if these two constraint functions are satisfied, then we call these the solution is a feasible solution. Okay, so in these two diagrams we generate multiple random solutions between these two dimensions. So the idea is optimization problem, we have start from the randomization. But optimization problem is always a heuristic based problem, so or we can say that a randomized problem with some guided knowledge. Okay, so in this case, because we have two dimensions and the variable bounds are given, so generally we generate a various solution space, a random solution space, by generating different random values of D and L, and try to figure out that between all the randomly generated values of D and L, between that bound are the feasible solutions. So in this diagram, only feasible space are drawn, feasible space is plotted, means these points are the solutions, and these solutions satisfy these two constraints. So we have a feasible space defined over D and L and satisfy these two constraint functions. Now based on the solution, when we put these solution into the f1 and f2, then this f1 f2 combination will give n point, and this point is denoted in the objective space as we have discussed earlier in the last figure. So for this problem, this is a feasible space, and from this feasible space the objective space is generated. Here both of the objective is minimized, so we have to minimize the f1 function and we have to minimize the f2 function. Fine. Now here if you are going to look this table represent only 5 solutions. So we pick some randomly 5 solutions to understand the concept of Pareto optimal solutions. What is a Pareto optimal solution? We take some 5 solutions. These 5 solutions may be any solution between this pool of solutions. And we denote some of the random values of A. Suppose A denotes 18.94, B denotes 21.244 for the dimension D, and for the dimension L there are some values defined. And based on these values, when we put these two values in this formula, it will give the objective function for weight, and when we put these values to F2, it will give the objective function value for deflection or end deflection. Now this point is plotted into the objective space. So this is the overall scenario. Now the next step is to find out the Pareto optimal set. How to find out the Pareto optimal set, and what is the Pareto optimal set? So let's understand the Pareto optimal set. So I have plotted a 2D space for the D and between D and W, which is objective space, which is similar to this one, but for only 4 or 5 solutions. In this one we have infinite number of solutions or many number of solutions. So to make a better understanding, we just deduce this diagram to sum of the objective space solution or objective solutions. So I have denoted these values into this graph, these 5 values into 10 values into this graph, or these 5 points into this graph. So by this graph, so don't look at exactly the point because it is a roughly estimation. So from this graph we can say, check that, because we have to find out which solution is better than other in order to find out the optimal solution. Our task is to compare, make a comparison between the solutions based on the objective or fitness function values. So if we look at the solution A and solution D, these two solutions, because this weight is to, we have to minimize both of the objective fitness function values. So the solution having minimum value of weight and minimum value of deflection is called optimal solution. So in A and D, because the solution A is a minimum weight than D, but it is maximum value in end deflection, so we require minimum end deflection. So A and D, we cannot compare these two solutions. So these solutions are also called non-dominated solutions. We will see in the subsequent lecture that what is a domination and non-domination. For the time being, we just see that when we comparing these two objectives, these two values, we cannot say that one is better than other or one is worse than other, because A is better in first objective but it is worse in second objective. So we cannot say anything about that A is overcoming the solution D. See whether B and C, see between B and C, suppose B and C. So solution B have minimum value of weight in this objective and it is maximum value. Same problem is here. Maximum value is in the second objective. So we require both objective to be minimized. Okay. So if we add these all solutions A, B, C, D, then this line represents a Pareto optimal front. This line is called Pareto optimal front, and the solution which lies on this line Pareto optimal front is called Pareto optimal solutions. Now what are these Pareto optimal solutions? So the Pareto optimal solutions are those solutions which are not dominated by other solutions, or we can say that which are not comparable and which are not dominated by other solutions. Now in this line the solution E is not there, so let's check about what is happening with E. Why I am not joining the E solution in this line. So let's compare C with E. So we have a solution C, we have a solution E, and this is a table. When we look for the weight value for C, so the C, the weight value for C is 1.43 and the weight value of E is 2.42. It means at first objective, the solution C have a better value. Check for the another objective. It is 0.19 for end deflection and it is 1.31. Yes, for the second objective also, solution C have a better value. So in this case, C is better than E in both of the objectives. It means when we found a solution which is better than another solution in all the considered objectives, then that solution dominate the other solution. So C dominate solution E. We write it as C dominates E, or we can also write it as E is dominated by C. We can use either of the language to explain this concept. Okay, so one more point is that there exist many solutions in search space that is dominated by at least one solution in Pareto optimal set. So we have various solutions available here, and there is at least one solution in all these solutions which is dominated by the Pareto optimal solutions. And moreover, there exists at least one solution in the Pareto optimal front which will be better than any of these solutions in non-Pareto optimal front. So at least one solution is there in the Pareto optimal front which is better than all these solutions. Okay, so in multi-objective optimization problem, the task is to find out the Pareto optimal solution, because only we are going to look for these solutions only. All other solutions are dominated by these solutions, so we are not going to waste our time in finding those solutions which are dominated by these solutions, because these solutions are better than there. Here the domination means better. If a solution dominate other solution, it means the solution is better, and we are going to search for the best and better solution in the problem. So we are going to search for the Pareto optimal fronts or Pareto optimal solutions in any multi-objective optimization problem. So the objectives of MMO is defined as we have to find out the set of solutions which are close to the possible Pareto optimal front. Now if I say possible Pareto optimal front, the meaning of that, see, in this example I say that this is a Pareto optimal front, but this is not the actual Pareto optimal front. Why not actual? Because I am considering only 5 of the samples, and which can be any sample in this feasible solution space. But it may possible that there exist many more solutions which may have lie here. Okay, so if I consider this diagram as the complete feasible objective space diagram, then the line which is nearer to this point zero, or this is the line which is showing here, because both are minimized, means the solution which are closer to the origin or closer to this side is optimal. Because we have to find out the minimum value in F1 perspective and minimum value in F2 perspective. So this line is denoted as a Pareto optimal front. And we are in multi-objective optimization problem is, we have to find a set of solutions which are nearer to the Pareto optimal front. So this is the Pareto optimal front, and we are interested in the solutions which are nearer to this front. And also the second objective is we want to find out the diversity in the solutions. More diverse solutions should be there. It is not like that all solutions are converges to one point. So we will see in the next lectures what is the concept of diversity in this case. So there are two objectives of multi-objective optimization. One is to find out the Pareto optimal fronts, or the solution which are nearer to the Pareto optimal front, and the second objective to find out the solution which is as diverse as possible. So I am going to stop this lecture here. I hope you can understand the concept of multi-objective optimization, why their mathematical formulation, and what is the meaning of feasible space, objective space, and what is the meaning of Pareto optimal front and Pareto optimal solutions, and what is the meaning of how we can compare the two solutions in the objective space. In the subsequent lecture, we will discuss more about the concept of dominations and how we can apply the non-dominated sorting algorithm in the given set of solutions. Further, this non-dominated solution sorting algorithm is used in finding the Pareto optimal fronts in NSGA2, which is an algorithm to solving the optimization, multi-objective optimization problems. So I hope you understand. If you have any doubt, then you can ask in the comment section. Thank you very much.